Well, auto dealers say they've been hit hard by safety protocols amid COVID-19, even as the economy prepares to fully reopen. Concerns linger on the future of the industry. Lloyd Allen has the story.
There is restrictions on local dealers being able to satisfy our customers.
Prior to COVID-19 and beasts like this, the 2020 Ram Laramie was a hot seller. Dealers say they're hoping for further lifting of restrictions to get consumers back in the saddle.
Vice President of the Bahamas Motor Dealers Association and General Manager of Bahamas Bus and Truck, Ben Aubrey, says despite some relaxation of restrictions, challenges continue for the industry, while customers remain ready for engagement.
Well, we're very credit-driven business, you know, so I'm sure that it will have some impact. I am somewhat of an optimist. I believe that, you know, you do have pent-up people that are pent up and they want to go out, they want to spend money, they want to be able to buy certain things. I have had a ton of inquiries via email and through our various social media points, and it seems like the demand is there.
Aubrey says safety protocols are an easy adjustment.
Social distancing is something that can be easily practiced, especially in this type of environment, allowing minimal amount of customers in, and then we're able to facilitate curbside service for pickup of those vehicles, wire transfers for payment. So it's something that can happen quite seamlessly, and it's steps and protocols that we're putting in place now so that we'll be poised and ready once the government gives us the green light.
According to Aubrey, tourism remains the missing factor for new consumer business, but for BBT, delivery fleets are a promising stream.
What I see in the short term for us as a company is that we're a company that I'm very fortunate that we sell inexpensive used pre-owned vehicles. We have inexpensive new vehicles. We have higher-end new vehicles, which I think are going to be less impacted because people that had money prior to this, most of them still do. But I think that the real bright light for us moving forward is going to be in the delivery line. You know, the PM has put a big emphasis on businesses learning to adapt to a delivery model.
While optimistic, Aubrey noted that the last vehicle sold for BBT was on March 21st, and with the looming threat of cheaper vehicles from China, it may be a matter of time before many dealers close their doors permanently. For the Morning Edition, Lloyd Allen, ZNS Network News.